Good morning, it's Karin Lanning and Crystal. We're here from the O'Brien Center at South Bend in, what?
Yes.
In Indiana. It's been a long week, but I'm glad you're here to join us for yoga. If you would like to have a block or a bolster, feel free to grab that. We are going to work again on relaxing into our poses. All right, I think we've got everything we need. Let's take it on down. Well, I lied, don't take it down yet. We're gonna have feet just below hips. Take that core in nice and tight. We're gonna inhale, breathe it all the way up. Exhale, take those arms wide, shoulders back and down. Just take a nice little gaze up. Inhale, breathe it up again. And exhale, bend the knees, come to a forward fold. All right, let that hand rest in front of the toe. Bend the knees softly. If you like to track your workouts, start your tracker. Let's take a nice inhale, bring the hands towards the shins and just stretch the crown of the head forward. Just taking a couple breaths here. Exhale, bend those knees a little bit deeper. Let the head hang in that forward fold. One more time. Coming up to that extended flat back. Elbows are pulling in. The crown of the head is reaching so we get that long spine. And exhale, come back to forward fold. This time, take that right foot back for our lunge. And we're gonna set up with that back knee down to the floor. We're gonna bring those hands inside of the foot. And let those hips soften. And we're gonna take just a minute here, letting this initial stretch soften those hips. Now, if you find that you need an extra pad underneath the knee, I've got double mats. You could fold your mat over and place that foot there. Crystal's got a mat, yeah, a squishy mat. So you could even just fold the edge of that mat over to put the knee on. So remember, just care for your body. Use what you have available. Hopefully you can feel your hips starting to soften a little bit, easing a little more towards the floor. We're going to walk that front foot out to the side just a little bit so we can use that elbow to open that hip up just a little bit more. And here again, we're going to just breathe and soften. Start easing down to those forearms. Now I'm going to grab my block. And use that block for my forearms. And you might be flexible enough at home that you can bring those forearms all down to the floor.
bit longer today. But we're going to be easing the positions a little bit as we go. So anytime it feels better to go back to a prior spot, feel free to do so. Keeping the core engaged. If you folded your mat over, take a little time just to unfold it. Now we're just going to sit back for a moment into child's pose. With the forehead rest. Bring the body back up. And we're going to switch to that other side. So right leg is forward. And we're just finding that initial stretch. Outside for the sunrise, huh? All right, if you're ready, take that foot just a little bit wider and see if you can just gently open that knee with the elbow. Ease down to those forearms. You might try it for just a moment? Those wrists just a little break. We're here for a little bit longer. Make sure you're listening to your body. Wider this time, and if you need to, you can use that block. That foot in a little bit closer to the hip. If you want to roll those hips over, go ahead. We're going to just start here and work on letting those hips sink towards the floor. So pull those shoulders back and down. Feel the lengthening of the spine. It's as if the crown of the head is reaching towards the ceiling. Find the right spot. That was it. That was the right spot. Well, you're finding that at home too. That sweet spot. Not quite painful, but definitely lets you know that you're hitting an area that's tight. Now, anytime you need to, if your knee starts to get a little tired, just come back out of this, sit down. Take the hands back and just let those knees relax. All right, if it doesn't feel comfortable, don't force it. All right, if you're ready, we're going to start to ease the body down so that the chest is towards that front leg. And again, you might decide that you want the block here for the forehead. close that. And then focus on the breathing. Taking it in slowly. Exhaling it gently through the open lips. Feel that beautiful stretch in the outside of those glutes. My hamstrings are usually tight, so I actually feel it there as well. My quads are super tight, that right quad might feel a little bit of a stretch as well. Let those shoulders relax so the upper body is just soft and supple. Up just a little bit. I want you to walk our hands over to this left side so that more of your chest is resting toward that front leg. And we start to stretch in towards that right rib area, as well as still getting that hip. So you decide, is there a little bit more room? Towards the leg, inhale, slowly lift the body, recenter the spine, and set those hips back. We're going to take that right hand behind and let those knees just roll up and over. Oh. Just take a few times to roll it back and forth. Poses a little bit longer. The goal is as the day goes on, you're going to keep that nice stretch. So it's not just a temporary fix. All right, let's bring it back to the front.
can take the other side. So gently help those legs reposition. Woo! Now it's time to get the other side. So you can again go to 90-90 if that feels good for you. Oh, that sun is really rolling up. I was trying to give you guys a different view today of the sunlight and the beautiful trees and ponds. Let's roll those shoulders back. Let those hips soften. And if you're ready to go all the way forward and down, feel free. Ooh, our music is really peppy. Makes me want to dance. But alas, it's not Zumba class, so I'll be hating myself. Did our yin yoga. We did one side all the way through and then the other side. And that's a nice way to do it because you don't always compare sides, which side felt better and tighter. But doing it right back to back today, just be aware of how each side of your body feels different. Perhaps you tend to use one side more than the other from an injury. Or maybe just not even recognizing it. So this is our chance to really see how our bodies are feeling. And utilize that information to maybe make some changes in what we're doing on a daily basis. So the comparison isn't for good or bad. Not flexible or flexible. Really just helping us to know more about our bodies so that we can make them the healthiest we can. So they last us a lifetime. And sometimes you might not have to use a block. You might want to anyways. Sometimes you can actually relax more by using a prop. Off to the right side this time. So hands walking over, chest comfortably resting towards that front thigh. Adjust the hips if you need to. So we take this extra time to get down deep into that connective tissue. Going beyond just the superficial muscles. Ooh. I don't know about you, but I'm feeling the side. I
stretch to recenter the spine. Set those hips down. Left hand comes behind. Feet stay right where they're at. Oh, yeah. Ooh. Thanks. Remember, we want to keep that core engaged right here. Chest is lifted, and you can ease back. Do a couple back and forth. I'm blaming those tight hips on CX Works. Ooh. Oh, ease it back. Oh, very nice. Well, we've had those legs stretched back quite a while. Let's take that right leg, tuck it in towards the left leg. And hips and shoulders are forward. You might want your block, possibly. Let's take a big inhale up. Brace the core. As you exhale, you're reaching forward. So as far as you can go, safely and comfortably, hands rest. And then we let the upper body continue to come to the floor. So at some point, your body's going to say, that's far enough. And then we're just going to rest here. So, depending on where that is, we want your neck not to strain. So you might use that block taller so that the forehead can rest on the block. And let's not forget our shoulders. Let them soften and relax. Now, I always find that I'm usually holding my muscles tight come into a stretch like this. Our goal is to let those quads relax, let those hamstrings relax, so that the body can really just stretch. So take those breaths. Think about where your muscles are still working. And let's try to let them take a breather. Relaxing back there? Okay. Can you stand a little more? Okay. So if you need a breather at home, take that breather. If we can take just another minute here, let's do that while we're here. I find it hard to stretch through the day. So once we've made that commitment, we need to get the most out of it. Thank you. to walk those hands back. Soften, let the muscles in the legs brace the core, squeeze the bum, keep the head in line with the spine. Ooh, just a little offset of those forward folds. And then setting those hips back down. Fabulous. All right. We're going to come to our backs for a little while. I think I have to turn this way because of the sunshine. Not that I'm complaining. All right. Beautiful. Oh, I could feel those stretches in my back. Those deep hamstring stretches. All right. We're going to take the right knee. Cross it. Arms are going to come out wide. Slowly let those knees pull over towards that left side. Now, my block is too far from me, so I'm going to go up and grab my block really quick. So, yep, you're going to use that block just to find that spot that you can stretch. Crystal looks like she's already there. So you guys get there. I have to get rid of my mic pack. There we go. So we're looking for that spot. We can still have our shoulders on the ground. And we have a long spine. Arms are just reaching out. And open those palms up. Stretch a little deeper into the chest. So we don't have to have legs all the way over into the ground for it to be beneficial. So you're just finding that spot where it's effortless. Now, if you want just a little more spinal twist, we're going to inhale and turn the head and look to that right hand. That doesn't feel good for me, so I'm going to move my head back. But if that feels good for you, just start to let those shoulders soften. Just like all the other poses, we're trying to find that spot where we can let go of the effort of the pose. And it might take just a little while to get there. Close your eyes if that feels comfortable. Feel free. Feel those shoulders soften, the spine relaxing. Raise the core as you lift those legs up. Take that right leg off. And then reposition the hips so that the spine is straight. And then we come to the other side. And that's a pretty intense spinal twist, so we're not holding these quite as long, but still for a good 90 seconds. So again, find that comfortable spot. Oh, we hit a spot for Crystal, I hear. Brace the core, lift the head, and this time turn the eye gaze towards the left side. If that feels comfortable, you stay. And if it doesn't, you go back to centering the head. The hips, straighten the spine. And for Shavasana, I'm just going to bring my feet wide and let the knees fall together in the center. So find that comfortable spot for you. And we're just going to take a little bit of time here for Shavasana. Almost as if the whole class has been that time. Use that breath to ease and soften the body. And we're just sending a gentle appreciation through all of the muscles. Appreciating the work that we do on a daily basis for us. And pressing, coming to a seated position of your choice. Let's inhale, take a big breath in, hold those hands together, easing them to the heart center. Thank you for sharing your time with us today. I hope you are well, and I will see you again soon.